Hi, Days fans. It's Sunday, August 16th, and we're going to talk about Friday's episode. Let's start with Ari and Brady at the mansion.
The big Ari reveal. I think this is just her way of rubbing it into the world. Mm-hmm. Hey, this is what you're going to be missing, people. Look, you fired me. Don't get used to it, because you're not going to see it very often, but here it is.
And if you want to see more of Felicia Terrell's incredible body, we have a post on DaysTalk.com.
Heck, we got people who are like going to go lesbian for her.
So, anywho, I thought Brady was pretty slick when he tells her what I think might be the quote of the day. Bathing suits are prohibited here.
Yeah, he's pretty slick.
So, they're cute. I don't know what Days is thinking. I understand the whole bringing Lindsay Hartley thing in because, you know, they need that extra publicity or whatever, bringing all those passions followers over, but you think they would have waited to get her to begin with, because now that they started this love story with the current Ari.
Yeah, I guess they're kind of, you know, taking the feedback from the viewers that they didn't like this Ari. She kind of grew on me. You know, new characters don't always grow on me straight away. Like,
right.
Will, I didn't like. It's a little buggy back here, so.
Yeah.
But I like Will a lot now, and I'm starting to like this Ari, so I guess they took the data and said, we got to make changes, and they did, and certain person became available, and away they go. So, anyway.
Stephanie and Sammy are hanging out
What
now.
Is that about? I mean,
I guess they
gee,
made
they're
nice.
All like BFFs again,
I mean,
for the first time.
It makes sense because they're cousins, but I'm thinking it's because Sammy helped, or Stephanie helped Sammy out, or was going to with the whole Johnny custody thing. She was going to testify, so maybe they bonded or something. Rafe. I thought the scene with Rafe and Melanie at the hospital was hilarious. Melanie's all babbling on, and, well, you know, I'd like to help you with this Anita that you supposedly like. You know, that was his cover for why he was in the computer. But, you know, I kind of decided I wasn't going to matchmake anymore, and blah, 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 blah. I love how they can just walk up in the middle of the hospital and plug the zip driver. What is that?
Thumb drive. I like how he, I'm sorry. He goes into the elevator and then walks right back to the computer and gets the information he needs.
He's got chutzpah then.
Yeah, well, he's FBI, you know. He's trained to do that stuff.
So, let's talk about the Sierra stuff. So sad. I thought Hope was keeping it together pretty good. You thought she should be crying more.
Yeah. Does she have a boob job? The mom?
The
pathetic babysitting mom?
Yeah, I would most likely think
okay.
so.
Okay, all right.
I hadn't really noticed, but I'm thinking she seems the type. So, what else?
Let's talk about the Kyriakuses. I think they're trying to up the evilness on the Kyriakus side. Because I always think the Dimeras, they're like far worse than the Kyriakuses. Like, I mean, the Kyriakuses are rich and powerful, but they don't, like, do really bad things. But now, Victor's like, screw that guy. Philip, why are you even bothering with him? Don't worry about his family. You need to get a thick skin.
I like, this is the second quote of the day. If you want things to be all nice and easy, go be a kindergarten teacher. And I'm thinking, that is the dumbest statement I ever heard. I don't think Victor would make it one day teaching kindergarten. That takes some hardcore, it's not for sissies, hanging out with a bunch of five-year-olds all day long.
I noticed in the scene with Sammy, Stephanie, and Maggie, a very unusual combination of three women in the same room. I'll bet they have never had a scene together in the history of Days. I could be wrong, but I have a feeling.
Well, Sammy had this clip, I guess they call it dry boarding or something, where she had some clip on her Facebook page, and there were scenes, and everybody's getting all excited because Nadia, you know, the one that plays Chloe, was dressed and everything, so they're thinking, oh, Chloe's going to come out of the coma soon. But for all we know, she was just showing up for work. I don't know. She was all in makeup, but Sammy was saying how she never gets to have scenes with Chloe. There aren't really that many scenes together, and you think there would be considering they both have been in love with the same man recently.
Hmm. Did you think Ari was wearing a wire the first time she went to the mansion?
Yes, I did.
And that's why she couldn't go swimming, and she had to go home, and, you know.
Because she was like, I can't go swimming right now. But it might be because that, that drug dealer guy was going to be meeting her back at the,
You don't think she's trying to get Brady in trouble, though.
No, I do. No, I think there is a very good possibility, because when she was talking to that drug dealer guy, and he said, "Don't get caught," and she said, "Don't worry, I've got a cover." Mm-hmm. No, I think she's DEA. I don't think she's a drug dealer.
Yeah.
But I think her cover is going to be, if she gets caught, she's going to blame it on Brady because he's got a history. Let's talk about the whole Nathan and Melanie.
Oh, my
Stephanie,
God.
The cheating heart.
Melanie, Jesus.
Melanie, God, have some pride. You look like a friggin' idiot the way you went off like
totally.
That.
Totally. She was just completely out of control. If there was a shred of possibility that they could get together, it is history. I mean...
But,
Nathan
you know,
has just lost complete respect for her.
Nathan's being an ass, if you ask me. Because he was, she had every right to be upset. Now, she didn't know. I mean, the way she came flying out of there, she didn't know. But we know the way Nathan's looking at Stephanie. It's wrong. You don't take Melanie out and be all excited and lead her on when really you want to be with Stephanie. How many times does Melanie have to be second choice to Stephanie?
But, you know, he doesn't need the drama. It doesn't do you any good.
But, you know...
It looks bad.
Melanie, you just knew when Phillip's down at the docks, all bummed out because Daddy yelled at him, "Didn't I say to you, oh, here's going to come Melanie?" And
yeah.
She just walks around the corridor.
Yeah.
And
another little
gonna,
serendipitous scene
yeah,
all a day
they're totally
going to
comfort each other.
Yeah.
Nathan and Stephanie are going to be together for a little while, and Phillip and Melanie, and then they'll switch and then back and forth just forever. It's going to be the new foursome. And they say this is a common thing in soaps. They have four young people. I think it's usually teenagers, more like Kenzie, Will, Chad, and Mia.
Yeah.
But this is a slightly older foursome that we're going to be seeing for a while, I'm sure.
Hmm. So, Sammy ran into Rafe.
Oh,
at
yeah.
the hospital. Kind of awkward, but
of course, he wouldn't tell her why he's there.
Yeah, very unrealistic.
More lies, more evasions. So... You know, like, JB keeps saying, do you think they're going to get back together? I don't even think they're fully broken up yet. You know? That's not done. Don't worry, everybody.
Oh, what else?
I think pretty much...
Bo, freaking out.
Oh, so we saw the actual scene that he's been having the premonition about. We saw him actually going through that sequence where he finds Tommy Bear, and he's like, ah.
But I like his freak out scene.
Yeah. So that's very disturbing. They found the car down by the river. I don't even want to think about what's going on there. Lots of people think maybe Patrick Lockhart has come back. I don't know if what they're thinking there is if he's being portrayed by a different actor or what. But then it wouldn't be so creepy because maybe he considers himself the dad or... Well, he knows he's not, but...
Right, but he could be mentally ill.
Yeah. So in the scenes for tomorrow, we've got Brady and Daniel...
I can't remember what they were talking about, obviously about Daniel's case.
Yeah, no, Brady's going to help him get to Kate.
Oh.
And then Melanie and Ari.
What are they talking about?
I don't know.
And does Philip quit? Does he quit the Titan?
He might, because
yeah.
that would be a chance for him to get Stephanie back,
yeah.
and then Melanie will be like, oh, great, I'm second choice to both
of you.
I
want him to really quit. I want him, you know, I like
yeah.
this powerful guy... Titan of industry, whatever, but it'll be kind of cool if he can break away from Victor
yeah,
and do his own thing.
Yeah, go teach kindergarten.
How about, you know,
he could be Sierra's teacher.
Yeah, I want to see him in a different, you know, headspace or whatever,
mm-hmm.
not this, you know, gotta, like, kill it, crush it, or whatever.
So Bo and Hope are going to be putting up a $5 million ransom. Did they get that from Daddy Kirakis?
They must have.
When did Hope suddenly become rich where she's giving all this money to autism and whatnot?
Yeah,
I know she's a Horton, but they never really played her out to be the little rich girl before. So, I don't know. But that's all for today.
That's it. Have a great Sunday night. And what do we always say?
The couple that watches stays together.
Stays together. Perfect.